As the majority of the world is currently under a shelter-in-place order, now is the perfect opportunity to finally finish those project cars. You can't work on your car without the right tools, so these are the top 10 tools that I suggest every P1 Volvo owner should have in their toolbox. I will be providing Amazon affiliate links in the description below. If you're interested on any of the tools that I have, please consider using one of those links because it helps support the channel. Number one is a basic metric tool set. What I have here is the 227-piece Cobalt set that I got on Black Friday about 10 years ago for $100. This set has all the sockets and extensions I've needed for about 95% of the things I've done on my cars. It's great for P1 Volvos, it's great for any other car, and it's also great for household projects. Number two, Torx drivers. There's a lot of Torx screws on P1 Volvos. Personally, I believe all screws should be Torx head, or star bit as some people call them. You also want to get some regular screwdrivers, but these Torx screws will be a lifesaver when you're working on a Volvo. Number three, a rubber mallet. Any professional shop in the world is going to have a hammer or mallet. A rubber 3-pound or 5-pound mallet is great for helping break loose seized bolts, especially if you don't have an impact. Jeremy Clarkson isn't wrong in that the hammer is one of the most useful tools that you can have. Any DIY Volvo mechanic should consider having a dice unit and a laptop dedicated to Vita. However, I would also suggest investing in the iCarSoft unit. iCarSoft makes handhelds for just about every manufacturer of vehicle, and they make them specific to that vehicle, so they can do a lot more than your standard scan tool is capable of. I've had an iCarSoft handheld for just about every different make of vehicle I own, and they have been absolute lifesavers. This Volvo unit has been especially helpful because it can clear SRS codes. This handheld does cost about $100, but it can easily fit right into the glove box so you can take it with you anywhere, and if you have to take your car to the dealership for diagnostics, this thing can pretty much pay for itself in one use. A perfect example is when I had an ABS error. Now, the standard OBD2 scan tool that I had said it was an ABS error, but then when I plugged in the iCarSoft, it said it was an ABS fault with the front left wheel, so I immediately knew which sensor was bad. This is able to read all the Volvo specific codes. Now, some of these units are also capable of being used as standard scan tools on other models, so I would highly suggest investing in one of these. If you're only going to have one OBD2 scan tool, some loud noises. If you're only going to have one OBD2 scan tool, I would highly suggest making it an iCarSoft unit. One of the only pieces that is missing from the Cobalt set is a 36mm socket. This giant socket right here is pretty much useless for anything except for P1 Volvo oil filters. If you can, I would suggest trying to find a socket that's about half this size because this can be just a little bit tall to easily fit a wrench on the top. My next suggestion might sound silly, but it has been an absolute lifesaver. It is this small little 1/4-inch ratcheting wrench. You can use it with a bunch of little bits to tighten or loosen. It might seem silly, but this makes access to so many screws so much easier. If you're trying to remove the wheel well liner, you don't have to jack up the car or remove the wheel. It makes it super easy to just reach under the front bumper and loosen any bolts that are under there, or if you're trying to access hose clamps in awkward areas. The best thing is that since it works with most bits, you can use it for any sort of screwdriver attachments as well. Number seven is a torque wrench. Ideally, you want a torque wrench that can go up to about 100 foot-pounds, maybe even more. Now, I'll be honest, I don't torque most bolts to spec. I've taken my cars off-road, and nothing's fallen off. As long as it feels tight, it's usually good to go. Ask any Volvo Master Tech or Indie Shop, and they'll probably tell you the same thing. The only two bolts that are truly worth torquing to spec are head bolts and wheel lugs. I don't trust shops to work on my cars because even the Volvo dealership has stripped my wheel lugs. being able to torque those wheel lugs to spec is vitally important. You don't want your wheel to fall off, but you also don't want to strip a stud. Now, when removing the head, you may want to get a smaller torque wrench, something that's a little bit more accurate. Now, this large torque wrench only cost me about $30, and it's close enough for government work. Now, the Cobalt set does come with a bunch of standard wrenches, but I highly suggest investing in a set of ratcheting wrenches. These style wrenches are great for quickly removing bolts that you can't fit a standard socket onto. Now, you might prefer to use an electric impact for removing and tightening a lot of bolts, but I personally like to do it all by hand. That way I can feel if I'm starting to cross-thread something, or when loosening, if it feels like the bolt head might break off because the threads are seized. So being able to use a ratcheting wrench makes the job a lot easier. Now, sort of a little bonus, I would also suggest getting these offset wrenches. Offset wrenches are great, especially on Volvos. If you're replacing the struts, these are a great tool to be able to access the center strut bolt. And they're also just great for being able to reach up in awkward areas, such as the end links, or if you're trying to remove sway bars. These ball end Allen wrenches are an absolute must. If you've ever replaced the compressor bypass valve on a Volvo, you probably found that it was almost impossible to do without a ball end Allen wrench. And after using these, you'll quickly find that these are much better than any standard Allen wrench that you can buy. Number 10, a Volvo specific locking tool set. It would help if I didn't open this upside down. You get the idea. If you have to remove the head, or you're removing the cams, or doing the timing belt, it's vitally important to be able to lock the cam gears in place together, and also block the engine in at top dead center. Investing in a Volvo locking tool set is very important for any DIY Volvo mechanic. Now, these are compatible with a number of different Volvo engines, and while it might be something you only need once or twice during your ownership of the car, it's really not too expensive to buy, and you can probably sell it used on the forums for 80% of what you paid. So if you're going to attempt your own timing belt service, buy one of these kits, complete the work, and then sell the tools. Bonus, a butter knife. It is me we're talking about after all. I consider the butter knife the same as a bone tool and a flathead screwdriver. What are some other tools that you would suggest P1 Volvo owners should have? Let me know in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe, and feel free to check out some of my other videos. And please, take this stay-at-home order seriously. The sooner that we shelter in place, the sooner we can level off this curve and finally get back out there for enjoying track days, mountain roads, and just having fun with our cars.